This is awesome, dude. Thank you. Good chat.
I'm so cold.
I'm very cold because I am in Lapland and it's minus 15 degrees and I got invited here by a friend of mine and it'd be cool if he was here but currently isn't. So we're gonna try a little magic trick, bear with. And here he is! Look at him, Romain Lanery,
hey.
One of my closest friends. His YouTube channel is TechNews Test.
Only in French.
Only in French, so I'm going to be doing most of the English speaking, but if you want to see a French video, there's my French channel or his French channel. We're going to be filming all of this.
My B-roll, dude.
Yeah, his B-roll. He's been doing a lot of the B-roll, but we've been really good mates since we were about 12 years old. We went to school together, and yeah. He called me up only like a week ago or something and asked me if I wanted to come here to Lapland. We're in northern Finland.
10 years after.
10 years later, yeah, exactly. Literally 10 years later for us to go on a little trip to test the new Tesla Model 3, a car I'm sure you've all heard of, a car I'm fascinated by. It's a company which is growing so quickly and really evolving our automobile industry as we know it. And we are gonna get into the Tesla, we're gonna drive it on ice roads and then an ice track on the frozen sea.
First time for me.
Yeah. First time for him, and he's gonna start off by driving. There's many things, three main things now. Lots of sun, lot of snow, and many Teslas. This is a Model S, as you see right here. And then Romain and I are going to be in this Model 3, which is actually really nice in this blue color. And I think it looks great, but I'm so pumped to be driving back on snow. And also this car, I think one of the biggest cars and most important cars I've ever test driven. Just describe it as one of the biggest cars. It's not biggest, like metaphorically for most significant. You know what I mean. This is the exterior of the car. The Model 3 falls under the Model S, and as you can tell, it kind of looks typically Tesla with a little difference. Because it's an electric car, obviously there's no front grille, which gives it this typically Tesla look. We've obviously got the Tesla logo here, but the front lights are very different to on the Model S. And then a few similarities are the general overall shape. This car's a lot smaller. This one obviously got crazy winter tires, but we've still got the similar design rims with the red brake calipers. And here for the autonomous driving, we've got cameras. There are cameras sort of all over, see, even in the B pillar right here. And then the door handles are actually really flush, which helps aerodynamically and design wise. And you press here and it sort of comes out like that. So that looks very, very nice. And then round back, again, very similar to a Model S, but the lights are slightly more cut out. That's how you can tell quite easily. But from the back, it's hard to tell really a massive difference, which is pretty cool. The interior then on this red car, beautiful red car. Now then, the beauty, think of this, the theory behind this is the beauty is in the simplicity. This is probably one of the most simple interiors you'll ever see. Yet it has so much going on behind it. One of the most complicated cars, which is the simplest to drive and also the simplest design-wise from the outside and from the inside, with all the cameras I mentioned, which are hidden all over the place. Forgot how to speak English. Right, inside, let's close the door. Not much to talk about really, because there isn't really that much. As you can tell, there are only two buttons on the entire interior of this car. This one here and that one right there. There is nothing else. No glove box button, no buttons around. The only other thing you've got is the door. You got your windows, and then you got the door handle is a button as well. So that's the only other real button. But then you've got a mix of leather. So as I mentioned, this is the performance model, and then Alcantara as well. A little bit of this sort of fake leather up here, which does feel a little bit cheap, I'm not going to lie. But then again, this isn't their top of the range. Now, one thing I love is this air vent. So all of that you see there, which goes all the way across, that is all one massive air vent, which you can control if I click here. Boom, there we go, right here. So see, you can grab and you can decide where you want it, how high you want it. It's awesome, awesome, awesome. And one step ahead of even what's in the Model S and X. Obviously, now that we're on this screen, let's talk about this. This is where everything happens, basically. It's why there are no buttons. As you can tell, you can open the boot. You can do everything from here. You unlock the car, you got your heated seats, you got your air con and all of that. But then you've also got all of your car settings. So for example, if I want to adjust the steering wheel, I press there, and then these buttons are set so that I can adjust the steering wheel. See? There we go, it comes out in like that. So that's pretty cool. And then you do your lights from here, you lock the car, the display, everything. Here he is. Hello. So yeah, everything kind of happens from here. And the car actually comes with its own SIM card as well. So that's why this screen can sort of load so quickly. I mean, now we're obviously putting it through its paces because we're in the middle of the sea, but it's still loading really quickly and it's such good quality. And this screen as a whole is just really, really nice. It feels nice, it's really responsive, unlike a lot of other screens of this scale. So everything kind of does happen here. You can control, you know, it kind of feels very Apple-like. I mean, you can go on the web, you can basically just do whatever you want. It's also set up for the autopilot, this one, that does not come standard on the normal Model 3s. The standard Model 3s do not come with this. You need to get the performance or option it out. But every single one will come with the cameras so that you can always upgrade to autopilot. The seats are very familiar. And then the rest is pretty simple. I mean, look, behind here, Romain, who set up his camera, you can see that the rear window is absolutely massive. So there's no sort of pillar right there. It's just one big kind of sunroof. And then you've got another sunroof here. So there's only these two little pillars that stop this from being a full glass roof, which is very, very cool and actually makes the interior feel very airy. The steering wheel is a lot smaller and a lot thicker than on the Model S and Model X. And I actually prefer the way it feels. I think it's time to talk about how this car actually drives. We're on an iced up sea. Actually, I was about to say lake, but this is the sea, which is completely iced up. We've got about 80 centimeters of ice behind us, and I am absolutely bricking it. I'm terrified. All right, guys, you might hear a little bit of radio talk in the background, but we are in the Tesla Model 3 right now, and we are gonna be driving it on ice. Very, very cool. I'm just doing a slalom right now, and I'm astounded by the amount of grip that this car actually has. It's really rather surprising. It's got dual motors. So one motor in the front, one motor in the back. That means the motors kind of adjust themselves depending on how much grip you've got. It's really, really cool, and it's a whole new way of kind of doing the whole four-wheel drive thing. And it's so nice and so instantaneous. It'll adjust itself basically instantly. Now, this car is the performance car, so sort of top of the range, but still cheaper and a little bit slower than a Model S. So it'll do 0-60 in 3.5 seconds, but it's still so quick. The thing with electric cars is you'll get that instantaneous torque. You don't need to wait for it to spool up. It'll just go instantly, which on ice makes it really rather fun. Now we're driving on some pretty bumpy surfaces right now. But the car inside, what's really nice as well, is the visibility. You've got a massive windscreen in front of you, these big windows and loads of sunlight coming in. And overall, with it being quite a short wheelbase and a small car, it actually feels really rather controllable. This is the ultimate test of what it feels like when you're driving on track. So hopefully we're going to be able to get it a little bit sideways so you guys can see a little bit more of that. But I am very impressed, and in fact impressed enough that I have already been a big fan of the Tesla brand, but I believe this has just become my favorite in the lineup. So we're just pulling up on a track right now. Let's see what this short wheelbase can do. So it starts slipping. You can feel the traction trying to give a little more power and grip to the front instantly. But it's crazy how quickly it adjusts to give you the power from either front to back. And then you can just slide it on the power really nicely. It's such a smooth feeling car, so predictable, even though most traction controls, so we're driving in sport mode now, not track mode. Most traction controls actually feel like they're taking away most of the driving experience. Whereas this one, you actually can properly sort of feel what's going on through the wheels. And even though it's a whole new system, it doesn't take much adjusting. Overall, I mean, what they've done with the whole dual motors and everything, it's a little bit of genius, if I'm honest. And with the regenerative braking as well, it's basically one pedal driving. So when you lift off, it uses the kinetic energy of the pedal to brake the car. It's usable, it's got two boots, you can drive it whenever you want, and it's got plenty of power. And on a track like this, it is actually surprisingly good fun. You wouldn't think that like a 3 Series competitor could be this much fun on a nice track, but it really is. And it will get sideways at speed as well. That's a quick little review of what it's like to be able to drive this car on track. The Tesla Model 3, very, very impressive stuff. Those were my first quick impressions of the car. Obviously driving on ice, you don't know exactly what it'll be like on the road, but I think it looks great inside and out. And honestly, I just really, really like the concept of the car, and I'm so impressed by how far Tesla have come so far. We also did go out with a professional. This is awesome, dude. Thank you. Good chat.
This is a funny car.
Wow.
It's a funny car.
Yeah. It is a funny car. I think he thought it was a funny car. Huge thank you to Romain, as always. Thank you from the English channel. Thank you from the people for inviting me. He's Freeze. Let's go. But yeah, no, that was awesome. So subscribe to his channel if you don't know it, and if you speak French, because it's all in French. But it's been awesome. So cheers, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it informative on the Tesla Model 3, a car I know a lot of people are interested in. And we'll be back with more videos very soon. Cheers. Bye-bye.